Hi, so after I finished that video, I realized I still want to talk about a few more things, so here they are condensed. I went through all 10 boards that I received, and actually 11 now that I'm counting them. Oh well, that's... I'm not complaining, that's nice, but I sorted them into three groups, the perfect ones, the ones with slight defects, and then the ones which I don't think will be particularly useful because of the defects they have on them. So let me quickly go through them. These boards, I mentioned previously I couldn't find the routing tab, but that is actually not the case. I was able, it's just in a slightly different place. You can see right here. In fact, there is little tab here, but it's okay. So I just picked a sample from the perfect category. Let me just show you what kind of defects you can expect on the in the perfect category. So the first board is all good. The vias are nicely centered. It will focus for me. No problem there. The pads are clean. Of course, I'll need to take some isopropyl alcohol and clean it before any actual soldering. But that's pretty good. No centering issues, no nothing. Let me just show you something I found on the other side of this board. There is some pretty bad case of silk screen smearing. I'm not sure what happened there. But I don't think that was supposed to happen. Oh well, it's not like it will influence the functionality of this board, it just doesn't look too pretty, but this is the back side anyway, no one will see it. So, that's fine. Now, let's move on to the second category. All of these in the second category have some drill centering issues. So, you can see the drills are not perfectly aligned with their vias. Like, I've got a feeling in some cases it even gets out of the via. But the insides all seem to be plated anyway, so it's not like there is no electrical connection. It's just... you wouldn't want this on a like high reliability, high performance board, but for this little project it's not a big deal. Yeah, it's just little cosmetic imperfection, but oh well, for such low price, these sort of defects are really to be expected, it's fine. So, one more thing I wanted to show with this particular board, this little crater in here, I'm not sure if you can see, but like right next to the via over there, not sure what it is. I'm suspecting it's just the solder mask doing something it's not supposed to do. I'm hoping it's not that via shorting to the ground, because that would be bad, but well, I will see what happens. Allegedly it's all electrically tested, so that should not be a short, but it just doesn't look too pretty. But other than that, it's fine. It's like these boards are fine to use. So that was the second category. And now for the third and biggest one. This disappointed me a little bit because there is this recurring defect, which I'm not sure why it is there, but nearly all of these boards seem to have this little blob of silk screen on that little pad over there. On the SOT666 left bottom pin, there is this blob of silk screen which I'm not a fan of. This other board, you can see it has goop all over the place and on that little pad. I'm not sure why just that little pad which gets silk screen all over it, but it seems to be the case with most of these boards in the failed category. You can see a bit of silkscreen gets to this pad as well. Yeah, and one thing I wanted to mention was also the poor centering. Like, this centering is not really that good at all. Then the next board. Again, we can see this goop on the pad. Not sure what's up with that, like why that is happening, but all of these boards seem to suffer from this issue. And also the centering isn't really all that great. Now next board, again we have this same goop on this same pad. Not sure what that is, didn't notice that before. I was probably just some gunk. Yeah, I definitely would want to clean the whole board with isopropyl alcohol before using it, because it's not really all that clean. But that's okay. Yeah, this centering seems fine, but if you look at the other side, you notice that it's in fact not fine at all. But in terms of centering, it's not as bad as the last board. Because look what I found in the last board. So it seems to me what happened when they made this slightly larger hole, when they drilled it, a bit of debris got inside of the hole diameter, and then only then they plated it. So this bit of debris actually got plated as well. I'm not sure if you can see it very well. That bit of stuff is actually plated in gold, so that is finished, that is part of the finished hole, and yet it looks like this. I can't imagine how stable solder joint on that would be, how electrically reliable that would be. Because this is the battery power line and it's surrounded by a ground fill, so you definitely do not want these two to touch, to short. Because if that happens, you short your battery, and that's really bad news. You don't want that to ever happen. Yeah. Well, other than that, there is not much else to say. Like, I got one board extra, and only two of the boards ended up being without any major defects and blemishes. So, I mean, I only really needed two, one for prototyping and one for actual production, because then the rest, I already came up with a new revision, so I don't need this these particular boards. So I'm fine with such big losses, but like, only in this particular case, not in general. Like, I'm not happy about such wastage. That's not good. But oh well, it's $5 spent per 10 boards. So really, if I would pay $5 for two boards, that's like $2.50 per board, and that's still a really good price. So I'm not holding this against PCBWay. It's just slightly disappointing, but again, I'm sure all of these boards would work too, and if I would really try, I could perhaps make, not this one had a bad drill, but maybe this one I could rely on. Maybe this one, I would try cleaning the goop from the pads, but that's, like, I'm not sure what it happens, whether it's a problem with the process or like what happened, but it's strange seeing the same blob of goop on the exactly same pad. I'm not sure why, but oh well. Yeah, well, this is probably the actual conclusion of the video, and because I have nothing else to say, and when I'm done with soldering these two, I might show the result, but it will probably take a while. Until then, be good.